Hello everyone, it's Axel from SEGGER. Today I want to talk to you about J-Link Configurator. And J-Link Configurator is a neat little utility that lets you see all the J-Links, J-Traces, and flashers that are connected to your system. Like most other J-Link utilities, it's part of the J-Link software and documentation pack. So you can go to the SEGGER website, download that, and after you install that, J-Link Configurator is part of the installed utilities. After you start J-Link Configurator, it goes out and looks for all the probes from SEGGER that are connected to your system. And in this window up here is all the probes that are connected via USB. And in this window down here, you get all the probes connected via the network. J-Link Configurator shows you various columns about the connected products. Here's the type of product that you have connected. In this case, I have a J-Link Pro, a J-Link OB, a Flasher Compact connected through USB, and then I have a J-Trace Pro and a J-Link Wi-Fi connected through TCP/IP. These probes can also have nicknames, so if there's a nickname assigned, you will see that here. This column has the serial number of those probes. For the ones that are connected through USB, you have the serial number again, which is used as the USB identification. On the TCP/IP side, you have the IP address and the MAC address of those connected probes. And you can also see if your probe needs a firmware update. So this column shows you the latest firmware version for each individual probe that is available on your host computer. And over here is the firmware version that's actually on those probes. And if J-Link Configurator notices that there's a discrepancy, then it'll show you that the firmware on the probe is outdated and should be updated. So in my case, I have two probes that I should probably update, the Flasher Compact and my J-Trace Pro. So if I wanted to update the firmware on my Flasher Compact from January 20th version to the February 14th version, I can click right here and then say update firmware, confirm, and then J-Link Configurator will perform the firmware update for me on this particular probe. And I will see that update as soon as I turn the auto refresh back on. You can also configure your SEGGER probes through J-Link Configurator. So if you double click on any of these, the configuration window will show up and you can review the settings. There's some general settings. You can enable or disable the virtual COM port if that probe supports this feature. If the connected probe allows IP configuration, you can select between automatic and manual. And on some probes, you can also change the USB driver if you wanted to do that. Default is, of course, the SEGGER J-Link driver. My J-Link Wi-Fi has an additional setting here. This is where you configure the Wi-Fi configuration for your J-Link Wi-Fi so it can connect to your network. J-Link Configurator also detects if probes you usually have connected go offline. So if I unplug my J-Link Wi-Fi and I turn the auto refresh on, then you can see that the J-Link Wi-Fi that used to be there now cannot be found. So if you have a whole bunch of SEGGER J-Link, J-Trace, or Flasher probes connected and one of them goes offline for some reason, you'll be able to notice that immediately with the auto refresh setting. If you'd like to find out more about J-Link Configurator, you can also go to the SEGGER Wiki and look up the page about J-Link Configurator and you'll find a description here. So in a nutshell, that's what I wanted to tell you about J-Link Configurator. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please check out our other videos about the G-Link family. Thanks for watching.